Welcome to my first ride out for a while. Good afternoon and welcome to my first ride out for a while. It's been 3 weeks since I posted a bike video. Various reasons to do with life. Life. Don't talk to me about life. Yeah, I had a good little run for a few weeks, but then various duties caught up, not least care responsibilities, and they have to come first. So I haven't been in the workshop for 3 weeks. Poor Andrew, chap who's waiting for the 1950s Rally and Humber to be returned. He only had a few little finishing touches to do, and I said to him, oh, be done by the end of the week. And then things mounted up. Well, things hove into view, put it that way. Sometimes responsibilities just have to come first. This is steep. We're coming up over the Lancaster Canal, which we crossed a couple of minutes ago. We're not actually going over here, we're just coming to have a look. So while we're out of the wind for a minute, we're out on a bike that I call Golden Brown because it's golden brown. It's a favourite of some of you, I know. I think Helen in Doncaster is a big fan of this bike. It's the, I can never remember, early 1980s, it's either 1980 or 85. I can't remember which of my Gazelles is which year. And it's a Gazelle Solide. 26 inch wheels. It's Gazelle's equivalent to the Superb, the Rally Superb. But it's, the spec is different. This has got drum brakes, for example, and a bottle dynamo, because you can't get the Sturmey Archer hub dynamo with the drum brake as well. It's either or. And this is how the Dutch prefer it. I compared it in a back-to-back video. In fact, it was a duet of back-to-back videos with the Superb. They've both got pluses, they've both got minuses over each other. I do love this bike. It was in as new and written condition when I got it 4 years ago now. Four and a half, yeah. It's got a few miles on now. I brought it out today. A, it hasn't been ridden for a while. B, I'm going to change the tyres. I mentioned this in a workshop vlog a while back, and it's got the same tyres on as my 84 Superb at the moment, and I want these tyres for that bike, because the identical ones on that bike are getting a bit worn, and I want to put the originals back on here. The more supple tyre with a ribbed tread, and little Gazelles all the way around. I've mentioned them umpteen times, so I'm going to do that tyre change. So I thought I'd bring it out first. Again, it's very windy. It's usually windy here, but it's especially windy today. It was beautiful when I came out. Look at this though. High summer. Rural idyll. So we are at a place called Hollow Forth. The old outbuildings are now beautiful holiday cottages, but do not despair, it's not some city tosser that's got the place. It's owned by a lovely chap of my acquaintance called John, and he's instrumental in running the Fylde Country Life Preservation Society from that beautiful cottage. So applause to him. And if you're looking for a beautiful holiday cottage to rent on the Fylde, look at Moon's Farm. There you go, John, there's your plug. It was on his lawnmower when I came past, so I might try and stop in and say hello on my way back. So we're going for a ride around this little district. So we're about 15 miles out from Blackpool here. Not far from the A6. Preston, Garstang, Lancaster Road. If you're interested, there's a junction off the M6, joins the M55 to Blackpool, Broughton interchange. If you'd come off there onto the A6 towards Lancaster, you come through the village of Broughton, and then you're only a kick in the arse off where we are now. Incidentally, if any viewers watching my videos of the Fylde fancy coming for a ride, as long as the time's convenient, I'd be only too happy to meet up and have a poodle. Someone commented recently, why do the cars pass so closely? I think, in fairness, a lot of that is the wide angle of the camera. That Golf, for instance, the blue one, was fine. He kept well over, kept a good gap. And I realised that on the video, that might look like a pretty close pass, but it wasn't. It's nice to know that people have the videographer's best interests at heart. We're heading towards the village of Barton, which is actually on the A6, but we're not using the A6. Minutes we'll turn around. We'll head deeper into the countryside, away from the rattle-running traffic. There's quite a lot of this ride that I might have to miss out filming because of this wind. It's behind us at the moment, but soon we'll be going into it. Yuck. Tried mics with little wind socks on. They've proved unreliable. I've had to scrap endless segments for having no audio. The old station. There is Massey Ferguson 35 and the West Coast Main Line. As I was on my way out here, I came across a lovely little thing in a village, the Elswick Rose, an annual festival where they crown basically the village queen, I think, each year. So I took a few shots. So here's a few seconds of the Elswick Rose while I negotiate the A6. Cyclist and therefore not worthy of passing the time of day to due to my lack of lycra helmet and drop handlebars, no doubt. Sunday afternoon. One of the groups was a women's cycling club, all out having a great time, waving, saying hello, passing the time of day as they went past. So it kind of confirms to me it's not a roadie thing, it's a roadie male thing. Basically, it's a twat thing. smell it. It's haymaking season. There was one on the ground. So what do? My little tribute to the Amsterdam flower bike man. A brief respite from the wind for a couple of minutes. Which way? This way out. Because this is wind behind us, we've got to turn around and do a bit of the more major road, B road, which I will want to film. That'll have the wind in our face. Then we'll turn back off that and head on a nice little lane like this with the wind behind us. Therefore, we save your ears, at least to a certain extent. Look, the flower's gone and nobody said anything. Not one of you. Come on, hands up, who saw the flower go? Where's it gone? Last time I came along here, that there gate adorned with a row of dead moles hanging from the top bar, hung there by the mole catcher. It's the mole catcher's invoice. Hang up all the moles that they've got rid of from the field. Gosh, isn't that lovely? And they get paid by the mole. Isn't that stunning? It's got this out the front window. Sheddage. More sheddage. The house looks like an old mill, and it is by some water, even though it's been weeded up now. Absolutely idyllic. What a place. we are in what I would term the very cream of the Fylde here. You're not getting the full benefit on the wide angle. The standard wide view is never very good for showing scenery or even cityscapes, especially mountains and hills, which these aren't, and they just look more or less flat on my angle. Oh dear. Now I'll have that old mill, thanks. Or John's cottage that we saw at the beginning. Moon's farm. Beautiful as well. Gorgeous. And here's the main road. Out we come. Female says hello and smiled. One male looked grumpily downwards and refused. Several groups of male roadies ignored me before I was filming, and one group of female cyclists, roadies, all said hello. The women's ride was more of a social, but it just shows it's not the faction of roadies versus other people, it's this male roadie thing, that's what it is. Men are such tossers. Despite the wind, I'm spending a lot of time in high gear today. Always painted brick red. Used to have a matching little barn there. Last time I came along, it was there. And now that modern thing is up there. What a shame, I've always wanted to get a picture of one of my bikes in front of those big shiny red doors that they had on. A little pull up there. What finer cycling can there be? A ride like this just reminds me that a 3-speed light roadster is really all the bike I need. It may not be all the bike you need. If you live somewhere very hilly, but everyone should have one. So this looks to British eyes like a Dutch city bike, and you wouldn't really take it outside of out of town. Well, that's not correct. My big bronze one, the Cheetah, my big black Populaire, and I'd say the Black Union to an extent as well, are city bikes. Even by Dutch standard, they're mostly for going to work. This is built not quite so heavily, and it has the 26 inch wheels. This is definitely an all-purpose bike. Someone would have had probably something with a single speed back pedal brake, no front brake, and all my feet are upper feet, which is grandma bike or granddad bike. They would have used that for around town, probably with a big pickup rack on the front and a big milk crate. And this would be kept for the weekends. A look at that one for you. This bike came from Rotterdam originally, and obviously either languished in the dealer unsold because newer models came out and tastes changed, or this wasn't to the taste of Rotterdammers. Or somebody bought it and never used it, like the many late model rally superbs that seem to be popping up lately that have hardly been ridden. Someone's bought it and just not ridden it. I don't know, I didn't buy it from that person. I bought it from a dealer who deals in other bikes that saw this one. Regarded it as worth saving. Yes, I did thank him. I paid in early 2018 was it? No, it wasn't. No, it was October 2017. I paid 200 quid for it. Quite a lot compared to what I usually pay for bikes. I'm not a big payer for bikes, to be honest, because I see lots get offered to me, lots pop up, and so if someone's asking 200 quid I can find another one for 100 usually. I paid 200 for this because it was a bit special, and of course, as I alluded in a video that I made on the topic, I then went and took away its virginity. I took away its new old stock status. Lancashire Cycleway. I don't regret it, because I've had many miles of pleasure, and now I'll have many, many miles of great pleasure to come. As it is a keeper. And I suppose that I do have two price brackets. There's what I'll pay for a bike just to save it and then probably refurbish it and pass it on. And there's what I'll pay for a keeper. So yeah, it's ridden now. It's got, I don't know, less than 1,000, but more than 500 on the clock, I'd say. Certainly 1,000 kilometres. Hello.
Hi.
I suppose this bike counts in kilometres. As you gather, we're retracing our steps now back to Eaves, or back through Eaves. This scattering of places, scattering of old farms and houses is Eaves. Gallows Hall. Memo to self, don't come here on a Sunday, or at school run time during the week. I've experienced that one as well. Now then, hello.
How are you, Trevor? Right? I'm checking the cows.
There is an agricultural college about a mile away from Myers Cove. The old home of that Land Rover was from that place. Hello. Can't really see the hall, unfortunately. There's the touring cyclist of a certain age, at least my age, probably more. in its cycling cap, saying a cheerful hello. That's how we do it. We are the ladies and gentlemen of the road. We should behave as such. Really back where we started now. Remember I said we're 15 miles away from home. Notice that I'm riding this, and you'll probably conclude correctly that I didn't ride out here and I won't be riding back. I came out to do a little ride and film it for you because I've been feeling guilty about not doing any work. Bridge Marina. In fact, I'll stop on the bridge and give you a look. Down here, there should be a cute young lady sitting in.